Waking up never sounded so good.
Bear us your medical mumbo jumbo.
Hello!
Welcome in to Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton.
Oh, my.
News, weather, sports, and of course, all the local info you need to start your day.
Is that a real show?
No, it's somebody's making a joke. Forget it.
Talk of the Town on 103.7 WTIB, 94.1 WNBU, Cable 7 in Greenville. And now, listen or watch live at WTIBFM.com.
Everybody still awake? All right, big finish.
Now, here's your host for Talk of the Town, Henry Hinton.
Hey now, welcome into Talk of the Town. It's 8:05, 5 minutes after 8 o'clock. Good to have you here on 103.7 WTIB. I think we're still iced up on 94.1. So you folks down in New Bern that aren't listening are not hearing us. But you may be watching us on Facebook. I didn't have the heart to tell Colleen Roberts that we are not on in New Bern right now. But, you know, we have listeners on Facebook.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So welcome in. Heather King is here this morning.
Good morning.
We all got here on time. Everything went well. Michael spent a night at the luxurious Dewdrop Inn and Spa.
Five star.
Driving back to Wilson last night, he came up. Did your wife get mad that you were going to spend the night in a hotel without her?
No, she loved it.
She went, oh, good. I can watch what I want on television.
And I get to sleep.
Yeah. Well, what does that mean, Michael? That might be a little bit TMI.
Yeah.
Well, that might have been TMI. She says I snore, so.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
You know, they have machines for that now.
Yeah, they're called wife's heel. She just keeps kicking you. No. Works great. Gosh.
You need to get you one of those CPAP machines. Man, that's what I've been sleeping with that for years. I can't sleep without it.
Yeah.
It's very sexy, too, when you get in bed and put that mask on.
Oh, I'm sure it is.
Nothing screams sexy like a black mask.
Your wife can pretend she's sleeping with Darth Vader.
Hey, if that works, I'll take it, you know?
Make me a sandwich.
McGee, you're going to get in trouble on this show. You know, one of these days, you're going to say something that's going to get you in trouble.
It won't be the first time.
I think you might have just done it. All right, we've had reports from all over Eastern North Carolina. Be safe out there. The sun is up. I checked outside. No snow falling here in Greenville. Give us a report where you are on road conditions or whatever. We'd love to hear from you at 252-561-8255. We had a lot of calls already this morning. 252-561-8255. What do you have to report to help your friends and neighbors? Let's check that out. Today, other news, we didn't cover any of the other news last hour because we were talking so much about the snow bomb or the bomb cyclone. What was it?
Bomb cyclone.
McGee, Google that.
Yeah, I got to find out what that is.
Bombogenesis is where the bomb.
Bombogenesis? Is it a biblical term?
No, it's a meteorological term.
What does it mean?
It's very technical, but what I was reading is a mid-level cyclone and altitude and bars and millibars and things like that.
But, you know, we normally don't call things cyclones on this. We had that discussion last year.
That's true.
Because what is a cyclone and what's a hurricane? And
right.
And generally what we learned about that is it depends on where you are because it's the same weather effect. It's just called a cyclone in other parts of the world.
Yeah.
So if we – I mean, this was not a hurricane. This was – but it was a bomb cyclone? What does it say, McGee?
Bomb cyclone or bombogenesis, a popular term used by meteorologists, occurs when a mid-altitude cyclone rapidly intensifies, dropping at least 24 millibars over 24 hours. A millibar, measures atmosphere pressure.
I knew it was going to have something to do with millibars.
Yeah, it happens when cold air mass collides with warm air mass, such as air over warm ocean waters.
That's a joke we have when Matt's in here. Because literally, we'll be over here doing the show and watching him over there looking at computer models and stuff of weather. And I'm like, what are you doing, looking at millibars?
Yeah. Bombogenesis.
A bombogenesis.
And it sounds good. You know,
that sounds like a kid's toy. It's like, KTEL presents bombogenesis. Your kids will love it. Let's go to Mike on the phone at 252-561-8255. 561-8255. Mike, good morning. Where are you calling from?
Yeah, a little Washington.
Yeah, I heard you guys got it pretty bad down there. What do you got for us?
I got perfect donut conditions over here on 3rd Street.
Are you doing donuts?
Perfect snow, just donuts all day long if you want.
You know, here's the thing, though. If you're out there, don't be the guy that goes out there doing donuts and then wrecks his car.
Well, no, I was worried about tipping my van over, but there's plenty of space out there, so make sure the parking lot's empty.
Mike sounds like he might know how to drive in the snow.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm from Wisconsin, yep. So why waste the snow?
I was gonna say,
man, you don't sound like you got a Beaufort County accent. I got news for you.
Well, Packers.
You're used to this stuff. Go Packers.
Had to get that one in there.
He's a Packers fan in Eastern North Carolina.
I knew there was one. Right now.
All right, Mike. Be careful with those donuts, man.
All right. Speaking
of donuts, a Krispy Kreme, yeah, a hot glazed Krispy Kreme would be good.
Eating
right now,
donuts while doing donuts, that's a good idea.
Yeah, that's,
I can get down with that.
All right, phone in and tell us where you are and what you're doing this morning in the snow. 252-561-8255. 561-8255. We got another Mike on the phone. Where are you, Mike?
Mike, I'm in Coleraine up in Bertie County, and it's still snowing here.
Oh, is it really? Mm. Wow.
And it's drifted so bad, but I would estimate that we've got about a foot.
Wow.
You know, we said yesterday that you guys were going to be ground zero, that you were going to get it worse than anybody else.
Well, we really did. And then I'd say it's still snowing. I just looked at radar, and it doesn't look like it's going to be snowing much longer.
Well, you know, the thing about it is, though, if you're at Coleraine, you're right there on the Chowan River, which, by the way, is sacred water. It's where I grew up in that water.
The Ripley waters of the Chowan River.
The Chowan, but you know, you usually right along the river, you don't, because the river acts kind of like a water heater, doesn't it?
It does. It will frost. I can see the river from my height, and it will frost up Tiny Coleraine, which is a mile from me, three times before it frosts here because of the river.
Yeah, yeah.
And the temperature is usually 1 or 2 degrees warmer here than it is up Tiny Coleraine.
All right, Mike. Well, be careful up there. And, Mike, before you go, I want you to say something for me.
Okay.
Say this. There's a mouse in the house. Get him out.
There's a mouse in the house. Get him out.
No, say it like you would normally say it.
There's a mice in the house, get him
out. Yeah, exactly. See, I grew up with that accent, so I know. I grew up on the Chowan River.
I love your show, Henry. I listen to 103.7 all day long.
God bless you, my friend.
Thank you. Y'all stay safe.
Be safe down there in Bertie County. Appreciate that. You know, I what is that accent, by the way? You know, did they have it in Northampton County when you grew up?
There was some of that, yeah. Heist and
my sister still has it Tyne. Really bad. I kind of lost it because I told you how I lost it because I was a freshman at ECU and took a speech class, and we had this professor who was this very accomplished actress. She'd been on Broadway. In fact, I remember the year that I had her, she actually starred in one of the summer theater productions here called The Glass Menagerie. Remember the old Tennessee Williams play, The Glass Menagerie? But I remember we had to get up in front of the class. And, you know, you're in speech class. You had to get up in front of the class and give a speech. And so I was up there saying out and about and all this stuff. You know, I was 18 years old. I just moved from Chowan County. And I'll never forget, at the end of it, she was like, Mr. Hinton, what is that OU sound that you're making, that out and about? What is that? Say round about the house for me. So I went, okay, round about the house. And she said, that is so charming, but you need to lose that.
Yeah. See, I had Jim Reese at ECU, and he, you know.
Well, I had Jim Reese, too. And, you know, his whole thing was standard broadcast speech.
Yep. Yep.
When you had Jim Reese at ECU, who was the legendary broadcast professor at East Carolina, that was and Jim had an unbelievable voice. Professor Reese did unbelievable, and he, when he would, you know, if you do you'd be talking to the microphone, doing something in a broadcasting class, and he would say, Henry, You need to work on your standard broadcast speech. People listening on the radio, they want to hear a standard broadcast speech. They don't want to hear that out and about stuff.
Yep.
But where did that accent come from?
I don't know.
But
that's
you know, because the further east you get, like you get down, you know, I think it's a little bit of a takeoff of what you get down around Hatteras Island, where mm-hmm. they, you know, it's even more pronounced where they say, pronounced. It's even where they say that, you know, high tide on the sound side.
Yeah.
And but you know, you get a little further inland, and again up around Tidewater, Virginia, you hear the out and about, and on the eastern shore of Maryland, you hear it. And right down through northeastern North Carolina, up through like Bertie County. But then when you get over here, you don't hear it.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, but it is charming. It is charming. 15 after 8 o'clock. Where are you? What are you doing? We will not make fun of your speech if you call. 561. Well, maybe we will. 561. 561-8255, 561-8255. Let's get a break in. Heather's going to update us on the very latest from WITN. And more talk of the town, coverage of the cyclone, the bomb cyclone snowstorm here on Thursday morning, January 4th. We'll be right back.
All 2017 inventory must go here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
This is commercial truck season. Come see our great lineup of Ram commercial vehicles for all your work needs. Check out the Ram 2500, Ram 3500 with cab and chassis, Ram 4500 and 5500. Also Ram ProMaster and Ram ProMaster City. All 2017 Rams must go during Ram Power Days.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
We're not just introducing the 2018 Toyotas, we're reducing them. It's the introduction reduction at Greenville Toyota. 2018 Corollas, $149 a month. 2018 Camrys, $169 a month. Hurry to Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant MyChart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Why settle for a 2017 model when you can have massive reductions on a 2018 Toyota? It's the introduction reduction at Greenville Toyota. 2018 RAV4s, $179 a month. Plus, get our advantage at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
This is your WITN Morning News Update on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
Good morning with your WITN News Update. I'm Heather King. Snow totals across Eastern Carolina are varying, even across individual cities, because of the way snow is drifting with the winds that are continuing to blow. At WITN Studio on Arlington Boulevard in Greenville, they measured 4 inches of snow. But again, totals are varying due to the nature of this winter event. And winds are going to remain strong through the day, with sustained winds ranging between 50 and 30 miles per hour. Gusts up to 50 miles per hour will be possible along the coast. And an important fact here, temperatures will stay below freezing for just about everyone today. And that keeps most of the snow, sleet, and ice on the roadways. Wind chills will also be in the teens and 20s through the day. Highways and roads across the east are covered in ice, snow, or both, making for treacherous driving conditions. There are some road closures in Greenville, and we've also learned now that there was a fatal car crash in Beaufort County overnight. Beaufort County Emergency Management Director Chris Newkirk confirmed the fatality to WITN, saying it happened around 2:30 a.m. on a rural road just north of Washington. Newkirk says emergency responders arrived to find a single vehicle overturned with one person inside. No other information is being released right now until the family is notified. Thousands of people have lost power in this storm, and more power outages are possible as ice continues to coat power lines and the wind continues to blow. There are a lot of outages that have been resolved, though. The hardest hit area of Eastern Carolina is Currituck County, where nearly 9,000 people lost power during the storm. This is also where the National Weather Service had issued a blizzard warning as opposed to the winter storm warning the rest of the area was under. Large outages were reported in Beaufort, Carteret, Dare, Hyde, and Onslow counties. However, Virginia, in the Virginia Beach area, has about 38,000 power outages hit harder there. In other news today, the FBI released the name of a man who was shot by an off-duty police officer in Greenville, 35-year-old David Melton of Goldsboro. Greenville Police Department says Officer Timothy Green was shopping at Academy Sports in Greenville when a person told him that a man was allegedly shoplifting. GPD says Green confronted Melton outside the store, identified and showed his credentials. At that point, there was a struggle, and they say the man tried to attack the off-duty officer with a knife. The department says Green drew his firearm to defend himself and shot Melton in close proximity, and he died at the scene. The entire thing is under investigation. A fire claimed the life of an elderly woman. This happened yesterday in Lenoir County. Multiple fire departments had to be called to Randolph Farrell Road. That's in the Hugo area around 2:30 in the afternoon. Lenoir County Emergency Services Director Roger Dale says an 85-year-old woman was killed in that fire. They have yet to determine a cause. Those are your WITN News headlines. I'm Heather King.
Cold for today with the clouds clearing by midday. Windy also with highs in the low 30s. For tonight, breezy and frigid with lows in the low teens. For your Friday, windy and continued cold with highs in the upper 20s. Lows tomorrow night, very chilly, around 14 degrees for the low tomorrow night. And for the weekend, 30 and 40 degrees for the high, respectively, Saturday and Sunday. That frigid air will continue to stick around before thawing out begins on Sunday. And I did want to mention, too, that we just got an update from Brock Letchworth from the city that the city offices are closed today and there will be no great bus service offered today either.
No great bus service.
No great bus service? That's not so great.
Not great.
Especially today if people had to get to work today. But I guess the buses can't get out. I don't know. It wouldn't be safe to get them out there. I don't know. All right, be safe, everybody. It's 8:24. What's the temperature right now?
27.
27 beautiful degrees in Uptown Burbank. News and weather, a service this morning of the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. What a year 2017 was for Tire Property Management and Tire Realty. Again, record sales, and Homer Tire still the number one agent in Pitt County. Getting it done. I mean, getting it done in a big way. So, if you are looking to sell your home or lease your home, there's only one number to call, and that is 758-HOME, 758-4663. remember all the reasons that you should list with Tire Realty if you're going to sell your home, if you want to sell it fast. The 99-day guarantee. They guarantee to sell your home in 99 days, or you will pay no commission to them. And then there's no upfront fees. And then, of course, there's no long-term contract. If you want to get out of the contract, you get out of it free and clear at any time. Give them a call today, 758-HOME. It's the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. If you're going to sell or lease your home, you can lease your home. They'll do that, too. They need homes to lease and homes to sell. Market is red hot in Greenville. Well, I wouldn't say it's red hot today. Well, yeah, it is red hot, but it's got snow on it.
Yeah.
And, of course, if you're looking for a career move and you want to do professional sales, they're looking for salespeople also right now at Tire Realty. Visit them online, 99erfree.com or 758-HOME. 26 now after 8 in the snow. And Heather King is going to run off to the WITN studios now, but don't run too fast.
Yeah, I'll drive slowly and
be
appropriately.
Great to have you here this morning. Thank you for the extra effort to get here
pleasure.
In the snowmageddon.
My pleasure.
Appreciate you being here. Heather King. All right, let's get a break in. We'll be back with more right after this on Talk of the Town.
Some pretty incredible things were born in the Carolinas, like barbecue. Born right here, baby. First in flight. Maybe you've heard of it. Mini golf. Boom. And a few of my favorites, the Panthers and Pepsi. Born in the Carolinas. The touchdown dance, perfected in the Carolinas.
All 2017 inventory must go here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
This is commercial truck season. Come see our great lineup of Ram commercial vehicles for all your work needs. Check out the Ram 2500, Ram 3500 with cab and chassis, Ram 4500 and 5500. Also Ram ProMaster and Ram ProMaster City. All 2017 Rams must go during Ram Power Days.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MYVIDANT to learn how you can sign up.
Welcome in to the new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Are you ready to drive a little to save a lot? I'm Rod Emery, General Manager at Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Come see us here in Washington for the best deal on a new car, truck, or Jeep and a great sales and service experience.
Lease a new Ram Crew Cab truck for just $299 a month and only $299 due at signing during our Drive and Discover event.
We're looking forward to seeing you at Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, located on Highway 264 in between Greenville and Washington, or visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com.
We'll be right back. All right, Talk of the Town here this morning. We are live on 103.7, live on Facebook, live on cable TV, live on cable channel 7. Good to have you here. We are getting, we had a report earlier that is still snowing up around Bertie County, around the Chowan River area, coal rain earlier. Call us and tell us what you are seeing, 561-8255, 252-561-8255. Our coverage of the aftermath, or is it the aftermath? This is kind of the midst of the Snowmageddon 2018.
Might not be an aftermath until maybe Sunday.
No, I think it's going to be around a while.
So.
I think it's going to be around a while. Today's the day. We haven't really talked any politics this morning or political news. Today is the day that the hearing, the lawsuit's supposed to take place on the Duke doctor who is suing UNC Hospital and Duke Hospital for collusion. We talked about this yesterday. She's saying that she was working a job. She was at Duke, and she was negotiating with UNC Hospital for a job. And she got an email out of the blue saying, you know what, I just learned we cannot hire you because there's been an agreement made between the higher-ups at Duke and UNC Chapel Hill that we will not hire each other's doctors, which, of course, if true, would be illegal. And, you know, you got to remember, UNC Hospitals is a is owned by the taxpayers. So the taxpayers could be on the hook for this lawsuit. So that was supposed to take place today. We'll see if that happens. Supposed to be at the federal courthouse in Raleigh. And it did snow in Raleigh. I don't know how much they got in Raleigh, but maybe one or two inches.
They got some. I don't know if they got as much as we did here.
Where are you, and how much snow did you get, and what are the conditions where you are? 561-8255. 561-8255. Call us. Doug, you're on. Good morning, Doug.
Good morning, Henry. How you doing?
Where are you this morning, Doug?
I'm going to see your mama today.
All right. Chowan County.
I had to deliver a worker to the hospital this morning in Elizabeth City.
Oh, my.
Well,
how is it up there? Did you guys get we heard Bertie County got pounded. How about Chowan County?
Yeah, it's pretty bad through here. Belvedere and all, just I'm plowing through snow, right? I mean, it's tough. Elizabeth City, the winds are bad. It's bloated everywhere off the road.
Any idea how many inches you got up there in Chowan, Hertford, Elizabeth City area?
My guess is hard to judge the way the wind's been blowing. I'd say probably 8, maybe, something like that. I don't think we got 10.
That's a lot, though.
And yeah, I'm right here at the curb of Gladden. I'm inside of it.
Right there where I grew up. And I talked to my mom this morning. We were texting before I got on the air this morning. I made sure she had power this morning because I had heard that across the line there in Virginia that there's a lot of power outages. But have you heard of any right around there where you are?
Not yet. I hope I got it when I get back home. I live on the Burke Road, and we lose it a lot there.
Oh, boy.
I'm not on Dominion. I'm on the REA.
What are the roads like up there in northern Chowan County?
Pure ice. My bad. I just hit some right there and went over my vehicle. it's bad. Really bad.
Well, be careful, my friend.
All right, I will.
All right. Appreciate it, Doug.
Good talking with you.
All right. Yep, bye-bye. Give us a call, 561-8255. 561-8255. Brian Smith is bringing donuts. We were talking. Laura Smith, who's on the air next door on 107.9, is mad because her husband is listening to, she says, Brian is now bringing your donut. He's listening to your show and not mine. What's up with that?
Thank you, Brian. We do appreciate that.
Thank you, Brian.
Mm-hmm.
Just what we need, you know. We'll sit around and get fat
again. Then we're going to go do donuts in the parking lot.
Exactly.
I can't wait. It'll be a fun morning.
It is a donut kind of morning, though.
It is, indeed. Indeed.
Let's see, what else is going on? By the way, I thought this was interesting, an article this morning in the News and Observer about the death penalty. You know, North Carolina has the death penalty, but we have not put anybody we have not executed anybody in the state of North Carolina since 2006. And now there has been some talk recently about bringing the death penalty. Well, not bringing it back, but actually using the death penalty in a couple of different cases. Number one, the cases up around Elizabeth City where the five people were murdered in the prison, the five prison workers. You know, what are you going to do to a lifer to punish him for murdering somebody? And, you know, does the state need to continue to pay to house and feed these guys? I mean, that's the real question. I have been very much on the fence about the death penalty. I'm a conservative, as you know, but I, you know, the death penalty's always been a tough one for me
because
I'm also a Christian, and I've always had a really hard time with the idea of putting someone else to death. I just don't feel like that's, you know, if that's a God thing, that's not a man thing. And I feel like that somebody who does what they do is going to get punished at some point. I mean, if you believe in the afterlife, you got to believe that.
Sure, sure.
So, you know, I've always struggled with the death penalty. But then came the case before Christmas in Onslow County of the little girl that was murdered. Well, we don't know yet. I mean, there have actually been no charges filed, no murder charges filed.
Which is interesting.
In that case of the little girl. What's happening there?
I've wondered the same thing over the course of the past couple of weeks. You know,
because they've charged the boyfriend with stealing some stuff. You know, stealing the dressers, which everybody assumes that that's what he was going to use to bury the body or sink the body or whatever. And they did discover the body, and didn't they discover it in water?
I believe so.
I'm trying to remember now, in a swamp area or something. But, you know, when it comes to the death penalty, when I think about people that would murder a three-year-old child, I don't know if they deserve to live any longer.
I'm with you on that. And 143, according to this article, inmates right now on death row. I'm with you.
So the Speaker of the House, Tim Moore, and Phil Berger, the President of the Senate, have accused Roy Cooper, the governor, and Josh Stein, the Attorney General, of stalling to keep people from being put to death because, as you know, the Democrats and the liberals have all been against the death penalty for so long. Berger put out a statement last week saying, for over a decade, death penalty opponents like Roy Cooper and Josh Stein have imposed a de facto moratorium on capital punishment in North Carolina using every legal trick possible to delay death sentences handed down by juries and deny justice to victims. No matter what they say, Cooper and Stein's indifference and failure to fight the moratorium endangers the lives of prison employees in close proximity to hardened murderers and nothing left to lose who see no possibility they will face execution for killing again. So I don't know if the governor and the attorney general are actually stalling, but if they are, it's time to stop. Because, you know, you got this Jacksonville case, you got the case of these prison workers, and you know, again, I have some real reservations about the death penalty, but I'm leaning in favor of, there's some. These are people that just don't need to live any longer. They don't. I mean, they're not going to contribute anything meaningful to the society at this point. They are a danger to others, whether they're in prison or not. And you know, maybe it's time to get on with it here in North Carolina.
Yeah. I just think certain cases, i.e. the case in Jacksonville or in Onslow County with Mariah Woods, that situation and others, I think those deserve very careful consideration of the death penalty.
What do you think? Let's take some calls on that. What do you think? Death penalty or no death penalty? 561-8255. 561-8255. Love to hear what you think now that the issue of the death penalty is now back on the front burner in the state of North Carolina, and the legislature comes back to work next week, so you're going to be hearing more about this. You know, with these murders in the Pasquotank prison up in Elizabeth City and this little three-year-old child in Onslow County, does North Carolina, I mean, those are cases that need to be considered for the death penalty, don't they? What do you think? 561-8255. Should we be executing people in North Carolina? I'd love to hear what you think. 561-8255. We'll be right back.
Some pretty incredible things were born in the Carolinas, like barbecue. Born right here, baby.
First in Flight. Maybe you've heard of it. Mini golf. Boom. And a few of my favorites, the Panthers and Pepsi. Born in the Carolinas. The touchdown dance. Perfected in the Carolinas.
All 2017 inventory must go here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
This is commercial truck season. Come see our great lineup of Ram commercial vehicles for all your work needs. Check out the Ram 2500, Ram 3500 with cab and chassis, Ram 4500 and 5500. Also Ram Promaster and Ram Promaster City. All 2017 Rams must go during Ram Power Days.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
All 2017 inventory must go here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
This is commercial truck season. Come see our great lineup of Ram commercial vehicles for all your work needs. Check out the Ram 2500, Ram 3500 with cab and chassis, Ram 4500 and 5500. Also Ram Promaster and Ram Promaster City. All 2017 Rams must go during Ram Power Days.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Okay, we're back at 8:43, and here's a bulletin. Krispy Kreme is open because Brian Smith just brought us donuts, and I'm going to eat one.
Right on.
I have done so good for the last. Eat the other half of that.
No, I'm going to get my own. I'm not going to eat. No. You eat it. No,
but
no,
if
no.
You don't eat that, I'll eat the rest of it.
I know you need to eat the whole thing. Go ahead. I mean, you can't just eat a half a glazed donut.
I have
know
done so good since Christmas.
You know you can't.
But I'm eating a Krispy Kreme right now.
Got to go ahead and do it. Might as well go ahead and do it. Got a whole box of glazed in here.
Mm. While I have my Krispy Kreme, here's McGee on sports.
All right, number one, UConn rolled by ECU in women's basketball on Wednesday, 96-35 to improve to 84-0 all time in the American Athletic Conference. Pirates dropped to 8-7 overall, 0-2 in league play. In fact, UConn's women have won also 42 consecutive road games. Quite the mark there for Geno Auriemma. ECU's men's team picked up their first conference win of the season, holding off USF 67-65 in Tampa. Kentrell Barkley led 4 double-digit scores for the Pirates with 16 points. ECU's back in action on Saturday on the road at UConn. The Pirates are now 7-7 overall, 1-2 in league play. Top 25 action from the men on Wednesday night. College basketball, number 24 FSU edged number 12 North Carolina 81-80. Number 25 Clemson held off BC 74-70. And number 8 Virginia cruised by Virginia Tech 78-52. Elsewhere in the ACC, Notre Dame dropped NC State 88-58. According to multiple reports on Wednesday, ECU football and offensive line coach Jeep Wade have parted ways. Wade was one of the initial hires made by third-year ECU head coach Scotty Montgomery in early 2016 and is one of numerous staff members since let go from the staff. I did find out on Wednesday that reports are that President Donald Trump will plan to attend the College Football Playoff National Championship game on Monday.
I saw that.
Yeah, they're expected to be guests of Nick and Jamie Ayers. Nick Ayers is chief of staff for Vice President Mike Pence and a native of Georgia. So we'll see if President Trump attends the game. And we'll see if ESPN chooses to put him on during the game. Who knows?
Do you have one more story? I'm not quite finished with my donut.
And this from the Charlotte Observer this morning. In the week since Panthers owner Jerry Richardson announced he would sell the team after the season, there's been a lot of speculation as to who the new owner might be. And a report from WCNC on Wednesday said that Brian France, the current CEO of NASCAR, is involved with a group to purchase the Panthers and make France the next majority owner of the team. Now, NASCAR came out with a statement shooting down the accuracy of that report from WCNC, saying that France is not involved in any way with the Panthers bidding process. But I do think he would he'd make a good majority owner of that team. I think he can certainly get the money together. Again, Brian France, CEO of NASCAR, reportedly that he could be involved with a group to purchase the Panthers. And their season could come to an end. Hopefully not, but it could come to an end this weekend if they lose to the Saints.
Must be negative.
Try not to be, but it could be. I mean, so we could find out sooner rather than later. You know what I mean?
Let's be negative, McGee.
Well, I hope they win.
Season could come to an end this weekend. So you could have reported that by saying, and the Panthers have an opportunity to extend their season.
They do, should they get by the Saints in the wild card playoff game.
You think they're going to get beat?
I do. I just don't have the confidence in the offense. I just don't.
Don't you owe me lunch right now for something? We'll do another bet.
No, you still owe me $1 from the Edenton-Tarboro game.
Oh, I do?
Just pay me later. We'll get squared away.
I like to pay my bets off. You didn't say that. Here's your dollar. Well, no, you forget all the food I brought you in the last year.
I'll give this to Mark Gittner because he's the one that brought it up the last time he was on. This is going to Mark. I'm going to write his name on it.
All right. It's 8:47, 13 minutes. I just got a video. I'm trying to watch it here, but it's hard. How do I widen this out? Randall Quidley just sent me a video from conditions or like at the Conley Ivy Road 43 area. That would be up around Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't look good, man. Doesn't look like anything's been snow plowed out there. You know, Brian just brought the donuts in, and he and I were just talking about it. They've actually plowed our parking lot, but it's worse now because what ended up happening was they plowed off the white fluffy snow that you could get traction on, and now it's nothing but ice.
Nothing but ice. Yep.
So I'm worried about that. We got some salt out there, Michael. We got the salt, didn't we? So we'll spread some salt out there so nobody busts their booty coming in. Let's see. We're coming up tonight on 103.7 at 6. We've got Tax Talk with the Kidwell brothers. Keith Kidwell and Proctor Kidwell will be live in the studio tonight. And that'll be 6 to 6:30. Jim Taunton and Financially Speaking will be on tonight from 6:30 to 7. So those shows should go off as planned, and we're hoping that the antenna problems that we're having this morning on 94.1 down in New Bern, Moorhead City, Jacksonville area will be solved by that time. But I will say this, it is a bright, sunshiny morning.
Which is good, yeah.
It is good, but the temperatures are still below freezing, so we still... You have to be concerned about the fact that even though the sun's out, that you're not going to get above freezing. There's not going to be much melting today.
Yeah, and who knows when the secondary roads are going to be able to be touched by any snowplows for the next 24 hours.
All right, it's 11 minutes in front of 9. Let's get our last break in. We'll come back and do our replay of our Jim Gaffigan laugh track this morning, which basically is the story of my life and my wife on the couch trying to decide who's going to have control of the remote. Which I thought was pretty good.
Yeah.
So stay with us. More Talk of the Town all the way. 10 minutes now in front of 9 o'clock. Careful as she goes this morning. Driving to work. We'll be right back.
We're not just introducing the 2018 Toyotas, we're reducing them. It's the introduction reduction at Greenville Toyota. 2018 Corollas, $149 a month. 2018 Camrys, $169 a month. Hurry to Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
The Carolinas, like barbecue. Born right here, baby. First in flight. Maybe you've heard of it. Mini golf. Boom. And a few of my favorites. The Panthers and Pepsi. Born in the Carolinas. The touchdown dance. Perfected in the Carolinas.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
All 2017 inventory must go here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
This is commercial truck season. Come see our great lineup of Ram commercial vehicles for all your work needs. Check out the Ram 2500, Ram 3500 with cab and chassis, Ram 4500 and 5500. Also Ram ProMaster and Ram ProMaster City. All 2017 Rams must go during Ram Power Days.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MYVIDANT to learn how you can sign up.
Why settle for a 2017 model when you can have massive reductions on a 2018 Toyota? It's the introduction reduction at Greenville Toyota. 2018 RAV4s, $179 a month. Plus, get our advantage at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
All right, we're back here on Talk of the Town. We got a few minutes left. We're going to do the laugh track in just a couple of minutes. But I thought it was fascinating. It's going to be interesting to see what happens now to the people who supported Donald Trump, who also thought that Steve Bannon was the brain trust of the Trump campaign. Now that those guys have just gone to war. And Bannon, you know, I don't really understand Steve Bannon's theory. I mean, if you take the people, look, Steve Bannon was a hero to the Tea Party folks and to the far right of the conservative movement because of Donald Trump. I mean, if you pit yourself against Donald Trump, those people are going to leave you. Donald Trump is the president. He's in a position to do stuff. Bannon is now a nobody. And on top of that, he's damaged goods because he promised he would deliver Alabama and went down there and ran Roy Moore's campaign and lost. I don't know anybody that could have really won that. But
yeah, that was going to be tough to do regardless.
Bannon, of course, is the guy who takes credit for linking Trump to the far right to get him a constituency to win the election. Trump, of course, as you probably know, tweeted yesterday that Bannon had nothing to do with my presidency. And I have a bigger button than he did. No, that was the other guy. Lawyers, according to ABC News this morning, lawyers on behalf of President Trump have now sent a letter to Bannon demanding that he refrain from making disparaging comments about the president and his family. Of course, you know, he said he even used the word treason when it came to his explanation of what went on when the Russian lawyer came to Trump Tower to try to give Trump some dirt on Hillary Clinton. Mm-hmm. And, of course, that's in direct conflict with what Bannon has said in the past, including what he said to Charlie Rose on 60 Minutes this fall when he said that the idea that there was any collusion with Trump in Russia was absolutely a joke and laughable. And now he's saying, oh, no, Donald Jr. organized the meeting and took, you know, the idea that those guys came to Trump Tower and didn't meet with Trump. Donald Trump, that is, senior, is just not believable. And how did he put it? He said the national media is going to crack Donald Jr. like an egg. So this is an ugly, ugly finish to the relationship between Bannon and Trump. But, you know, Bannon's created this. I mean, you know, Trump fired him. Got him out. There was all sorts of if you remember when Bannon was fired, it was pretty much known that Donald Jr. hated him.
Right.
But I guess Trump felt like he owed him something. So at that time, Trump didn't believe that Bannon had nothing to do with his presidency. But now Bannon, of course, has created the ultimate sin, which is saying that he'll run against Donald Trump in 2020. And he even said that this billionaire, Rebecca Mercer, who was a big, big financier of Donald Trump last year, is going to pull out and back him. So when he said that, Mercer announced yesterday, I want nothing to do with Steve Bannon in the future. I'm fully behind Donald Trump.
Yeah, Bannon's just digging that hole.
Yeah, it's just getting deeper and deeper, isn't it? It's crazy. So it'll be interesting to see where that goes. I mean, you know, for the most part, I don't know why we should care. Bannon's a nobody now.
Yeah.
Except that the far, you know, he claimed to be the Pied Piper of the Tea Party and the far right. And claimed to be the person that put together the strategy and the game plan that put Trump in the White House. And maybe he did. Maybe he didn't. All right, let's redo the laugh track this morning. Jim Gaffigan, our comedian, one of our favorites, and this is a great one because it's who controls the remote? Here's our laugh track with Jim Gaffigan.
I do like being married to a strong, decisive woman. But you know what? I'm in charge of the remote control. That's where I draw the line. All right. I'm in charge of the remote because I'm the man. All right. I mean, she picks all the shows we watch, but I get to hold the remote because that's the kind of puppet dictator that I am. Being in charge of the remote control is a no-win situation anyway. The person you're watching with is never satisfied. They're like, turn it up. I can't hear it. And then you turn it up and the commercial comes on. Turn it down. What's wrong with your hearing? I'm always in trouble. When we watch television, stop crinkling that bag. Once I got in trouble for sneezing. Why would you do that? I think it's involuntary. Well, now I didn't hear what that guy said. All right, I'll rewind it. Oh, now it's starting the whole episode over. Here, you should be in charge of the remote. I'm going to go back to hiding in the bathroom.
That's funny.
That's the story of my life with a remote, though. There's a button on my remote that just cuts the TV off, and I don't know what happened. And I have to go cut the machine back out. It's a
no-win situation.
Looking at video right now on Facebook from the Blue Point Restaurant in Duck. Currituck sound is frozen over. Everybody be safe out there. We'll see you tomorrow.